sun is racing.
Welcome, race fans, to another episode of the Rubbin' Is Racing Daily Fantasy NASCAR Show. It's Vegas, baby, on race day, baby. We've got all your action for the Pennzoil 400. Stages for this week's race are going to be at lap 80, lap 160, then they'll race the final 107 laps all the way to the finish. Your fun fact for this race is the last and the only driver to win from the pole here was Kyle Busch in 2009. Can he do it again as he technically starts on the pole today? I wouldn't be betting on it. The start time for today's race is 3 p.m. Eastern, and coverage has moved from Fox Sports 1 to Fox, so if you have your DVR set, you're going to need to change those. Then an hour after Cup race conclusion, we will follow it up with the second part of today's doubleheader, the washed-out Xfinity race from yesterday. Hopefully you have some action rolling on that. It'll make a really eventful NASCAR day. I'm looking forward to it. I know Liehr's looking forward to it, even though he's on vacation, and that's why I'm rolling solo. Liehr's wife surprised him with a trip to Florida, and so I'm rolling solo this week. Yeah, that's right. Liehr goes to Florida the week after Daytona. Makes sense of that. Anyways, I hope the guy's having a wonderful time on vacation with his family and enjoying it. I think I've got pretty much all the info you need that helps you get on a winning lineup this week. Let's get back to talking about the action, which is that three of the Toyotas for today's race will have to start at the rear. Kyle, Rowdy Busch, Denny Hamlin, and Eric Jones will all be scored from their original starting position. So Rowdy's being scored starting on the pole. Be very, very careful, because if they don't get back to their starting positions, they're already getting you negative points. It's something you definitely need to worry about if you're going to roster any of those JGR drivers. Since qualifying was rained out yesterday, the field has been set on points, which makes this jumbled mess that we dealt with a couple of times last year. Now, remember, this basically starts everyone where they theoretically should be in a starting scheme, which means there's not a whole lot of potential for place differential, unless you're using the statistics to try to find who's swapped points or who's in a better ride or equipment and carrying different points than what they had last year. It's a really interesting situation that you're going to have to be aware of when you're creating your lineup construction. I think it's important to remember that traditionally at this track, there are two dominators, so you're going to want to keep that in mind when you're constructing your lineups. Traditionally, those dominators come from a small group of guys. And historically, that group of guys is Keselowski, Logano, Harvick, Truex, and or Rowdy. Those are your guys' favorites to dominate at this track, and it's a combination of those guys. Like I said, two of them are usually required on a lineup, unless one of them's starting in the back and accruing points from place differential, which is not the case in this week for this race. So I think it's going to be picking two of those guys there that to dominate, the right two. I'm not sure which those two are. I'm generally gravitating towards leaving Rowdy off my list, which could be dangerous, but he also didn't seem like he was happy with his car in practice. I think my list, as we go, as we're looking at lineup construction today, is basically Kez, Logano, Harvick, and Truex, and that's where I'm going to make my dominator core from. If we want to look at the other practice data that I noticed while watching practices and analyzing it, Almirola and Stuart Haas Racing looks really fast, as do the Hendrick Chevys, and that's where you can get some place differential. The Hendrick team did not finish very well last year collectively as a team, at least a couple of the cars. A couple of those cars are a little overqualified, but that would be where I would look for place differential. They also looked really fast as well. When it comes to value this week, I think the important thing for me to tell you, guys, I don't like guessing on value plays and telling you this is what my gut's saying. But my gut is telling me that you want to avoid the guys that are overqualified. The guys that had really good seasons last year and finished really well, they're qualified on basically the best case scenario or close to it for where that car could finish. I don't think I'm going to roster those people, and I don't think you want to do it either. So just keep that in mind when you're doing your roster construction today. Remember, guys, to join the league. Last week we had a good throwdown, even though I didn't finish at the top. A couple of my drivers got wrecked out. I know Liehr had the same problem, but that's Daytona. Everybody says the season starts this week at Vegas, so hopefully we can take it down. Guys, it's one of the best leagues out there, and it's absolutely free. The amount of talent of the daily fantasy community that's in this league is just amazing. And we've had a wonderful time competing against everybody for the past couple of years. Really looking forward to it. And guys, I wanted to thank you guys for tuning in. Hopefully I gave you all the information that will help you start getting good lineups together and that can help you win some money today. Remember, if I'm not winning any money, I really hope it's one of you guys, but really I hope it's me. Guys, thanks again for tuning in. Remember to like, share, and subscribe. We will have Liehr back next week, barring any unforeseen circumstance. And that means a full show instead of one of these quick hitters. Thanks again, guys, for tuning in. Have a good one.